With the success of Diablo, Path of Exile, and other action RPG titles, Marvel Heroes is often overlooked. Are action RPG fanatics denying themselves the pleasure of beating the crap out of costumed bad guys, or are they right in foregoing Marvel Heroes in favor of the more popular action RPGs on the market? Welcome, my name is SirDutchie, and in this video I'll take a critical yet honest look at Marvel Heroes. Story. The Cosmic Cube is a device of untold power, capable of changing the very fabric of reality at the whim of its possessor. The brilliant but malevolent Dr. Doom has the cube, and with it, he aims to reshape the world in his own image. Determined to succeed where the cube's previous wielders have failed, Doom has lined up villainous allies to prevent the superheroes from interfering, and it's up to you to put an end to his madness once and for all. Graphics. Marvel Heroes looks pretty good with sharp textures and overall crisp and detailed character models. Each hero is iconic and easily recognizable not only by their appearance but by their animations as well. The environments range from crime-filled city streets to exotic jungles occupied by tribesmen, dinosaurs, hand ninjas, dinosaur head rockets, and other shenanigans you'd expect straight out of a comic book. A surprising and impressive amount of variety can be found not only in the many different areas, but the enemies as well. If you're at least somewhat familiar with comic books, you'll notice quite a few familiar faces too. I'd say the biggest downside to the graphics is just the amount of graphical effects altogether. This game can get ridiculously hectic on screen, to the point you'll be guaranteed to lose your cursor in the heat of battle. It's also a shame that most equipable loot items don't actually show on your character model. The looks of your character can only be changed by equipping a different costume altogether. Sound. The sound effects do a good job of conveying the powers of heroes, and the music is well chosen to fit the theme. Each hero is generally voice acted well with quotes that are definitely true to the character and often hilariously so.
To destroy you would be a petty victory indeed, and Doom is never petty.
Gameplay. If you're in any way familiar with action RPGs, this game is no different. Since the game features an impressive roster of heroes to play with, there's also quite a lot of variety in combat abilities, since it's possible to quickly and easily switch out your character with another without having to leave the game to do so. A big downside to this convenience, however, is that all characters share the same inventory, so trips back to one of the hubs to get rid of your items is certainly something that can eat up quite a bit of time if you play the game frequently. Despite all that, combat plays great and feels smooth, and characters generally feel pretty unique overall. Kicking ass as Spider-Man is a totally different experience compared to taking noobs to school as, say, Juggernaut, although I'd say that almost all heroes can be equally satisfying to play with certain impactful abilities that are not only true to the source material, but overall have a good sense of impact that generally makes dispatching those pesky bad guys delightfully brutal and fun. And if you're the type of player that really enjoys summoning playstyles, well, I got some good news for you, since there are more than a handful of summoning-oriented heroes in this game as well, such as Dr. Doom, Ultron, Iceman, and even Loki. Now, for an action RPG game, the game does have a good amount of content too, and most of it is fairly varied. For starters, you have a whole storyline to go through, which consists of many different environments, with hardly any two areas feeling the same. It's also a nice change of pace compared to other action RPGs that most areas are very modern. By going through these areas, you'll often see levels that are public, so while you're out there gleefully filling up the hospitals, it's common to see other superheroes do the same. This really makes the world feel alive and makes it incredibly easy to team up long or short term with other people, although it's hardly ever necessary due to the rather forgiving difficulty in the overall storyline itself. However, besides the storyline, you can also choose to play terminals, among a few other things like raids, one-shots, and danger rooms. Terminals are like contained dungeons with a boss at the end. These areas don't offer much randomization, but are nevertheless pretty fun to play through. Personally, I've played countless terminals on all difficulties, but because of the huge hero roster, there's more than enough variety to keep things interesting, and if you're at endgame level, it's also a very good way to measure one hero against another to see which one performs better or has a playstyle that more suits your tastes. I'd say raids are fairly self-explanatory, and one-shot stories are similar to terminals, but feature somewhat of an extra storyline in a much larger environment compared to terminals. There's also the Danger Room, which is in essence Marvel Heroes' take on randomized dungeons, comparable to maps in Path of Exile or Rifts in Diablo. Now, while you're out there kicking ass and chewing bubblegum, you run into loot. A whole lot of loot. In fact, I'd say this game possibly has the most loot explosions of any loot-based game I've played. It's borderline ridiculous, in fact, which compounds the fact that inventory itself is limited even further. But it's also extremely satisfying to see the amount of loot dropped all the time, providing a sense of achievement even if you can only play for 10 minutes or so. There are a ton of different items in the game, including many unique items that can only be worn by specific heroes. These items are typically huge stat sticks, so you'll spend a good amount of time weighing the pros and cons of each item when managing your inventory. Since the game is rather easy on normal and heroic, it's usually not really necessary to micromanage the hell out of your characters, but once you start playing the hardest difficulty, it really benefits you to optimize your hero in any way you can. And also, in this area, the game has enough depth to really make your hero stand out when wearing carefully selected gear to maximize each hero's potential. Which has the overall benefit of making the game incredibly replayable, given the large roster of heroes. There are over 60 heroes available. And you're not alone either if you run around cleaning house with a team up follower, which can also be surprisingly helpful to have around to take some of the heat off you or to provide some extra damage. However, all these heroes might sound fine and dandy, but don't forget that heroes are not free per se. Given that the game itself is free to play, the heroes cost money in tiers. You got 2 25 heroes, 4 50 heroes, 9 euro heroes, and 13 50 heroes. Overall, I'd say that performance-wise, a 2 25 hero is equally capable of handling all the content compared to the more expensive ones. Prices seem to be more based on hero popularity and the time it took to develop them. Now, it's entirely possible to play the game without spending a dime, since there's a currency called Eternity Splinters that drop regularly, and those can be used to purchase heroes as well. However, be aware that if you wish to obtain costumes, it's technically also possible to get them through crafting, but since there's so many costumes available and the chance to obtain them is random and quite costly, it's unrealistic to think that you can just obtain the one you want through crafting. Costumes are fairly expensive, but don't offer anything aside from occasionally some new voice sets and animations. And also, I'd like to mention that purchasing more bank space is not possible without spending money, and I can only assume Gazillion's main source of income is through the purchase of stash tabs, which are 3.50 for hero-specific tabs and 5 euro for regular shared stash tabs. I'd say that if you like the game, you'll probably want to buy one or more at some point or another, given the insane amount of loot. Now, once you reach level 60, you can continue to grow in power not only by fine-tuning your gear through enchants and the like, but also by investing in the Infinity system. This system is comparable to Diablo's Paragon system, with continued experience gained at max level to invest in bonuses that grant power to your character pretty much indefinitely. It's not the most exciting system, but for me it's the perfect carrot on a stick that gives me reason to continue playing on my favorite heroes even after reaching max level. You can also decide to simply re-level your character starting back at level 1 if you're into that sort of thing. Overall score. The good. Impressive number of heroes. With over 60 heroes at the time of this video, there's plenty to choose from. Useful team-ups. The team-ups are actually useful and can contribute quite significantly. Graphics. The graphics look pretty great, with a lot of graphical effects too, fitting the hero. Great level variety. Each area and level feels distinct and unique from one another. Casual friendly. The game is rather easy, with hardly any severe penalties for dying, making it the perfect entry-level action RPG for people that just want to jump into the genre without too much hassle. Fantastic atmosphere. The Marvel Universe truly comes to life in this game. Great deal of content. With patrols, terminals, one-shots, raids, leveling heroes, and the danger room, there is plenty to do. Events. The huge amount of events make the game feel fresh each time a new event takes place. The bad. Events. Ironically, the huge amount of events can trivialize regular gameplay, since often progress can be gained much faster during events or Midtown Monday. No appearance changes. No matter what armor or weapon you equip, appearance does not change aside from putting on a different costume. Crafting too random. Because of the random nature of crafting, it can feel more akin to gambling. Similar heroes. Out of the impressive roster of heroes, a fair number of heroes can feel a bit too similar. Cash shop pricing. Fairly high pricing in the cash shop and paywall items. I think costumes and stash are too expensive and I'm not fond of having items such as special team ups behind gambling paywalls. Loot management. There's just too much loot with too little actually being useful. Out of all the games I've played with inventory management, this one ranks as one of the most time consuming among them. The same can be said about comparing uniques. Limited storage. The starter storage is quite small and in no way big enough to store the amount of items you will need if you decide to spend a lot of time in this game playing different heroes. What I'm saying is, I'd be lying if I would tell you the game is perfectly playable with the stash space given. Because if you're in it for the long run, you will want to spend some money at some point. Inconsistent performance. Stuttering is quite common, especially in multiplayer areas. Closing words. If you ask me, I'd say the game is good, just not spectacular. Initially, the game hooked me because it reminded me of Diablo 2. And now, well, now I'm still playing. I've taken a few breaks here and there over the years, but personally I'm fond of the game and it always scratches that superhero itch. Is it worth it? Now, the appeal of Marvel heroes depends strongly on your enjoyment of superheroes. If you grew up reading comics or watching animated series, you'll have a blast stomping those inferior thugs into the ground as your favorite hero. It helps if you won't financially starve by spending a few euros here and there too. If you have no money but amazing financial constraint and patience to never spend a dime, you will still find an amazing and fun game here that's sure to entertain you for many hours. Now, if you absolutely hate cash shops, this game will most likely not be for you since the cash shop can be a vital element of the game given that it's Gazillion's only source of income. Personally, I've only spent cash on heroes, stash and costumes a few times, but the cash shop also features items that increase drop rates and such. I wouldn't call it pay to win at all, but spending money can save you quite a bit of time. My name is SirDutchie, thanks a lot for watching, and I wish you, as usual, a fantastic, heroic day!